Hey friends, if you are a project manager or senior scrum master, then this session is for you. This session is different because here we are calculating EVM but for agile projects with examples. So if you are preparing for project manager interviews or if you are preparing for PMI ACP or PMI PMP with new syllabus, then agile EVM is an important metric which you must aware about. Friends, please turn on caption for this video. That will really going to help you. Also, try to pause the video and listen again wherever required. Friends, in the end, if you feel that you have learned at least one thing new today, then don't hesitate to hit like. So one like is a big motivation for me. Let's begin. So friends, let's understand EVM in Agile. So basically, EVM in Agile is an adapted implementation of EVM that uses the Scrum framework artifact as inputs, use traditional EVM calculations, and is expressed in traditional EVM matrices. So Agile EVM required a minimal set of input parameters, that is the actual cost of a project, an estimated product backlog, a release plan that provides information on the number of iterations in the release, and the assumed velocity. All estimates can be in hours, story points, team days, or any other consistent estimate of size. The critical factor is that it must be a numerical estimate of some kind. Here, we will use story point as a measure of story size and velocity. Now friends, let's do some comparison. Agile methods do not define how to manage and track cost to evaluate expected return on investment information. Therefore, the iteration burn-up chart as used in Scrum do not provide at a glance project cost information. Agile matrices neither provide estimate of cost at completion of the release nor cost matrices to support the business when they consider making decisions like changing requirement in a release. Agile EVM does provide this information and is therefore an excellent extension to the information provided by the burndown charts. Let's see what is our baseline. So we are using three data points to establish the initial baseline: the number of planned iteration in a release, the total number of planned story points in a release, the planned budget for the release. In order to calculate the EVM Agile matrices, there are four measurements needed. First, the total story point completed, the number of iterations completed, the total actual cost, the total story points added or removed from the release plan. The comparison of the earned value against the planned value lies at the core of the EVM. So, planned value is the value of the work plan for a certain date. It is the entire budget for the work to be completed at the planned date. In Scrum terminology, it is the sum of the estimated feature size for all the features up until the planned date. So the EV or the earned value is the value of the work completed at the same date as used for EV. So earned value is not synonymous with actual cost, nor does the term refer to a business value. Basically, the earned value refers to the technical performance earned against the baseline or the work plan. In Scrum terminology, it is the sum of the estimated story points for the feature up until the calculation date. And the actual cost is what the name implies, the cost in dollar to complete a set of features. Let's see an example to clarify these three concepts. With the total project budget of 175k and having completed one out of four iterations, we have this product backlog and these actuals. With this information, which is easily available in any Scrum project, it is easy to calculate our three base values. Expected percent complete equate to the number of completed iterations divided by the number of planned iterations. In our example, after iteration 1, we should be at 25% complete. EVM at Agile work by comparing the current release plan taking changes in requirements into account against the actual work performed. We can see at a glance that our project is in trouble. The earned value is less than the planned value, that is EV equal to 35K and PV equal to 43,750. It is important to note that in Agile EVM, there is no credit for the partial completion. The backlog items are either done or not done, that is 0 or 100%. In keeping with Agile terminology, a backlog item is only complete and story point awarded when the customer accepts the item as done. The CPI or the Cost Performance Index gives a measure of efficiency. It shows how efficiently you are actually spending your budget dollars compared to how efficiently you plan to spend them. It is calculated by dividing earned value by the actual cost. In our example, CPI is 35K divided by 65K equal to 0.53. A CPI of 1 indicates that you are spending your budget to accomplish work at the rate that you have planned to spend it. A CPI less than 1 means that you are over budget, that is, you are spending your budget less efficiently than planned because your earned value is larger than your actual cost. The estimate at complete is the forecast of the total amount that we will need to spend to complete the planned work based on the actual work accomplished. The easiest calculation is to divide the total budget by the cost performance index. While this is not the most accurate calculation, it is accurate enough to identify trends in time to take corrective action. Our estimate at complete is 175K divided by 0.53, that's equal to $330,188. We predict to be 47% over budget by this calculation. The Schedule Performance Index or SPI compares earned value with planned value and is calculated by dividing the planned value into the earned value. Our SPI is 35K divided by 43,750, that's equal to 0.8. So we are 20% behind our schedule. The analysis of the SPI is comparable to the CPI analysis. And an estimated completion can be estimated by dividing the SPI into the planned iterations. In our example, we plan to finish the work in 4 iterations and expected to need 4 divided by 0.8 equal to 5 iterations. So when should we measure earned value? Iteration boundaries are well defined to calculate the Agile EVM. It can be done more often, which is applicable for a release that contains only a few iterations. EVM has been proven to be statistically accurate as early as when 50% of the planned features are completed, which make EVM and Agile EVM an important metric to report to your stakeholders. The important consideration is that you have the correct cumulative values available at the boundaries that you choose to calculate your Agile EVM. The most important question asked is, does Agile EVM allow to change backlog? And the answer is yes. The EVM in Agile method does take into account the changes to the backlog that may be introduced after each iteration. By using the changes to the backlog, the added or the removed estimated story point caused by added or removed feature, basically, you effectively re-baseline after every iteration. The effect of recomputing the Agile EVM after every iteration is the validation of the modified backlog against release plan. You are validating that you will be able to complete all of the work plan for the release within the both schedule and budget. This gives the product owner who owns the product backlog early information about the effect of his changes, early enough to reconsider changes if they affect the release plan negatively. Friends, please pay attention to this deck. It may be a little confusing. So when teams in a program are comparable in size and velocity, then the Agile EVM calculation can be made over the whole program. But we all know that often teams are not comparable. They work on different parts of the project with different velocities, different story points values, and different project cost. When the later scenario occurs, team have different characteristics. We need to calculate the earned value for each team and then add them up to a total earned value. The example shows how we did this for a program with three teams. Also calculate the planned value for each team and add them up for the total planned value. From there on, all of the EVM calculations remain the same, with the caveat that the actual cost needs to be actual cost across teams to calculate a total CPI across a program. The CPI and the estimate at complete are useful indicator or how the program is doing overall, but does not give you an indication of any particular team that may be in trouble. In this example, the total program is forecast to be over budget by 11%, 1 minus CPI, or 260K, and is 6% over time. By looking at the result for each team, you can see that team A is currently performing according to the planned cost and schedule. Team B is 20% over planned budget and 14% behind planned schedule. Team C is performing better than planned and the 11% under budget and 14% ahead of schedule. Friends, using these simple performance matrices in conjunction with the more typical agile matrices, the attrition burn down and the release burn up chart, for example, provide objective analysis to share with teams, management, and customers. The early warnings that the Agile EVM matrices shows validate changes to release plan and provide business with the opportunity to make priority trade-off decision early in the project lifecycle. Friends, thanks for watching this video. I'm sure you have learned something new today. If yes, please hit the like button. Your one like is a big motivation for us. And if you are new to our channel, please subscribe for more similar videos. Bye. Have a nice day.